I'm Dr. Matt Schindel. I'm a space historian and I'm a curator of planetary science and exploration here at the National Air and Space Museum. So people have been thinking about habitability and life existing on other planets in the solar system since at least the 17th century. And for a few hundred years before we even developed spaceflight, people were speculating about life on Mars and life on other planets as well. But it wasn't until we actually could send things out to the moon, to Mars, to the other planets that we really got to see what the surfaces of those worlds looked like. And when people got a close look at Mars, for example, which was thought of as perhaps the most Earth-like planet in the solar system, that we really started to think that maybe Earth was kind of, you know, special in our solar system in that it was a habitable planet. The other planets just didn't seem like places where life as we know it could exist. So Mars is a great place to look for life in the solar system, even though we don't really think that a lot of the life that we know today could live on Mars, at least not the Mars that we've come to know through spacecraft and rovers. We do think that microbial life could still live on Mars, and that there may have been a period way long in Mars's past, like billions of years ago, when Mars was a lot more Earth-like, when it actually had liquid oceans and an atmosphere that could support life. So far, we have not found life anywhere outside of Earth, but that doesn't mean that all of our searches have been unsuccessful. We've learned a lot about the history of Mars in particular, and time periods during which it may have been more habitable. It may have had, you know, lakes and even small seas that could have supported the development of life. We've been sending spacecraft to Mars since the 1960s. First, we flew by it with early Mariner missions, and then we went into orbit around Mars with the Mariner 9 mission, and then finally we landed on Mars in 1976 with the Viking 1 and Viking 2 landers. And since then, we've sent rovers to look for life on the surface of the planet, and we've continued also to study Mars from orbit. And so we've looked for life on Mars in a variety of ways. Viking looked for life by taking soil samples and throwing them into experiments that it carried on board the landers, looking for sort of signs that life was at work there in the soil, looking for signs of metabolism, that something in the soil would be eating or breathing and, you know, excreting things that you would expect a living thing to excrete. And since then, you know, with the rovers, we've been looking more for evidence in the rocks for possibly existing life, but maybe fossilized forms. So far, we haven't found signs of actual life on Mars, but we have found, you know, the chemical building blocks that life could be made from. We've also found ice on the surface of Mars that, you know, indicates that there is a lot of water potentially locked up in the dirt of Mars that may have once flowed freely on the surface. And, you know, from looking at the behavior of the ice at the Martian poles, we know that there is a lot of water there that's just not liquid water, but, you know, water that could have at one point supported life on the planet.
Let us know what you thought of this video down in the comments section. And if you enjoyed it, be sure to give it a like and a share. And follow STEM in 30 on Facebook and Twitter, and subscribe to the National Air and Space Museum's YouTube channel.